morning, Skeeters. Thanks for tuning in. I'm Gabriella Hendrix.
And I'm Natash Mutasa, and today is a B-Day, and this is your live Skeeto-Byte news.
Seniors, if you have not taken your senior picture for the yearbook, you need to stop by K6 and get the information from Ms. Long ASAP. Deadline is October 31st if you want your picture in the 2018 yearbook.
Attention all returning members of GEMS and any young ladies interested in joining GEMS. We will have an informational session on Tuesday, September 19th after school in room A3. GEMS is a mentorship club that works with young ladies to help them realize and reach their fullest potential. We aim to help build well-rounded, confident, successful women. Our club focuses on a wide variety of topics, including self-worth and self-respect, financial literacy, building healthy relationships, college and career readiness, and much more. If you're interested in signing up, stop by room A3 after school on Tuesday to get more information.
Did you know that MHS has a book club? It's called Skeeters Readers, and we will meet for the first time Tuesday after school in the library. Come meet new friends and discover new books and have fun. Skeeter Readers, Tuesday at 4 o'clock in the library.
FCA will be Friday, September 22 at 8 a.m. in the library. FCA is an awesome Bible study. We will talk about scripture and worship. Everyone is invited and bring a friend. You don't want to miss it. See you there, Skeeter Pride.
Dream, build, play. The Mesquite Cardboard Challenge is on Saturday, September 23rd from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. in the small gym at MHS. People of all ages in the DFW area are invited to come build anything they want out of cardboard and play with their creations. The event is free, and if you have any questions, please see Mr. Martin in K14.
Reminder from the SROs about jaywalking. When crossing the roadway and there is a crosswalk provided, you have to cross in the crosswalk when the sign indicates to walk. This means you cannot cross in the middle of Beltline. If there is a crosswalk provided and the sign indicates do not walk into the crosswalk. If there is no crosswalk provided, go to the nearest intersection and cross from one corner to the next corner, only when there is no vehicles approaching on the road.
Today, we are wrapping up our College Week celebration. Thank you to all of you that participated. The winners from Dress for Success and Be Your Own Hero are Lorraine Pastrana, Victor Shipman, Daisy Marino, Eileen Flores, AJ Friedberg, and Celeste Kano. Please come to Ms. Ashby's office after the announcements to claim your prize. Today in advisory, you will be working on decorating your door. You may choose any college you wish. Mr. Gonzalez and Ms. Ashby will come around to judge the doors Monday morning. The winning class will receive a pizza party. Teachers, please make sure your door has all the requirements included on your door. You can find this information in your College Week packet. Good luck. Our college celebrities today are Disney actress Miranda Cosgrove from iCarly, attended USC in California, and is working on earning her degree in education. Actress Wanda Sykes attended Hampton University in Virginia and earned a bachelor's degree in marketing. Actor Steve Carell, best known for the voice of Gru in the Minions movies, attended Denison University in Ohio and earned a bachelor's degree in history. The Monday night, September 18th, MISD Big College Fair at Eastfield College from 6 to 8 p.m. Hope to see you there.
And here is a message for Miss Bell.
Okay, students, this is an important announcement about attendance, truancy, and denial of credit. If you're going to be absent, your parent or guardian must call the attendance office by 9 a.m. to report the absence. The absence will be unexcused until we receive documentation. For an absence to become excused, you must bring the documentation down to the attendance office. Parents can only call or send a parent note 3 times for the entire year. That's state law. If you're more than 10 minutes tardy and you have to come to the office for a tardy pass, this counts as a partial absence, which is an absence in the court's eyes. It is your responsibility to bring the documentation to get it excused. We send warning letters after the student's been absent 3 times, 6 times, and 9 times, and that's partial days or whole days. On the 10th absence, the state requires us to file a truancy case. So the key to success is being present at school. Okay, on denial of credit, if you're absent more than 5 times in any one class, that's excused or unexcused, partial or the entire period. In a semester, you must make up the time, which is called recoup. We're printing a report each week, and the attendance office will be calling students in to tell you the number of hours you owe. The thing is, after you owe those hours, and if you are absent more, you're going to owe more, but we won't always be able to call you down. So you need to keep a check on how many times you've been absent. It is your responsibility to keep up on the number of hours you owe and document them. And if you have any questions or you need to find out about your attendance, feel free to come down to the attendance office, and one of the attendance ladies or myself will help you.
If you are a student that plans on parking on campus this year, you will need to purchase a parking pass. Mr. Samples has agreed to give a two-week window ending September 15th today to allow for students to purchase their parking pass. Students will need to bring their driver's license and insurance to the ticket booth before or after school to purchase their pass. The passes will be $20 for the year. Those students that refuse to purchase a pass after the two-week grace period will have their card booted until the pass is purchased or the owner/parent responds to the school with the current driver's license. The Hanby Stadium parking lot is where students will need to park their vehicles.
How to send your tip to the Mesquite High School texted tip hotline. Text to 214-695-9489, plus your message. You will always remain anonymous. Tip that leads to the arrest of suspects, as well as the recovery of stolen property and drugs, are eligible for cash rewards of up to $100, which are paid to tipsters on an anonymous basis. Help keep MHS safe, one text at a time.
Attention prospective Skeeter class officers. Application for officers will be accepted from Monday, September 11th through Monday, September 18th. Application flyers can be found around the school and are accessed using the QR code on the flyer. All applicants will have an interview, which will be held on Wednesday, September 20th or Thursday, September 21st in Portable 25. Portable's on the V-Hall side.
With this being College Week, we have videos of Mesquite ISD graduates that have reached their goals through education and hard work. Here's today's video.
This is Michael Harmon. He's a graphic designer, but before that, he was just like you, a student in Mesquite ISD. Michael set a goal and then made it happen. You can get here from there. Dream, plan, go.
Attention potential Skeeter class officers. It's time to sign up if you want to run for positions this year. Sign up can be done before or after school in P25, the portables on the V-Hall side, starting from Monday, September 11th until Monday, September 18th. Panel interviews will be conducted on Tuesday, September 26th and Wednesday, September 27th in P25.
Attention seniors, it is now time to order your official senior shirts and hoodie. Order forms are available in K3 from Ms. Ritter. An example of the designs are listed on the screen. Deadlines for placing your order with Ms. Ritter is September 22.
Attention freshmen, it's time to order your freshman hoodie. An example of what it looks like is on your TV screen. Forms are available in K3 from Ms. Ritter. Deadline for placing your order is September 22nd.
Exciting things are happening in the Swarm Press. Go to www.theswarmpress.com to read the latest news on campus and in your community.
And now, will you please stand for the pledges?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And now the pledge to the Texas flag. Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to thee, Texas, one state, under God, one and indivisible. It is now time for a moment of silence.
If you missed any of us today, you can find the news on our school website and be sure to like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter.
Thank you for joining us today. SSR is about to begin. I'm Natash Mutasa.
And I'm Gabriella Hendrix, and we are Maroon.
Skeeters out!